You're live.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the When Women Heal Monday Night Meetup. I'm your facilitator for tonight, Erica Bishop, and I am so happy to be with you this evening. I am so grateful for Tierra Destiny Reed and the When Women Heal platform for allowing me this opportunity to be here with you all on this Monday night. And I hope that you have started off having an outstanding week, having a glorious week, a magnanimous week, as we're in the eighth month of this year. We are truly turning the curve very quickly. So many things have happened, but we are so grateful for all that we have endured and embarked on and have been victorious in. So last week, when I was with you all, we were talking about effective outreach that you can do within your business and ministry. And we were just talking about a couple of different things that how you can expand your business through your marketing. But one of the things that we really touched on the most was collaborations and how important those collaborations are. As you learn, you sharpen, you develop, you exchange information. Tonight, we're going into 10 different ways that you can serve your community. Now, we all know that the pandemic has caused us to take a pause, slow down, and even pivot. And as we have had to take a pivot within the pandemic, there are still some things that we can do to serve our community and to serve the people around us, especially when you are a servant at heart. You want to be out there in the community and help the people around you. When you are a kingdompreneur, spirit-led entrepreneur, and you understand the value of sowing and reaping, and you understand the process of sowing seeds for your harvest, you want to be able to give your time, your talent, and sometimes even your tenth to be able to help those people around you. So tonight we're going to just quickly go through 10 different things that we can do when we're talking about serving our community. Now, as I was gathering this information, there was a couple of things that had come to mind for me. That yes, COVID-19 is real and the pandemic is here, but there are also some things that have not changed. And that means taking care of our senior citizens, those that may be widows, those that may be elderly, taking care of those that are homeless, and even those that may be challenged when we're talking about special needs. And also many of us have core passions around maybe animals, our environment, and just helping our community as a whole. So what are some of the different things that we can do to still be a part of the community? Yes, we know we have to social distance. We want to continue to do that. Yes, we have to have our mask on. We want to continue to do that. And we definitely want to make sure that we're taking the necessary precautions for those persons that may be at risk from a health standpoint. Yet we can still help them. Yet we can still serve our community. So one of the things that I want to talk about, which is up under a very big umbrella, many of the things that I'm going to talk about, is what we call random acts of kindness. Random acts of kindness. Now, the beautiful thing of it is we've slowed down a good little bit because we don't have the hustle and the bustle of many of the different things that we used to do. And we still do have a lot of people that are essential workers who are still working every day. But then there are some of us who do have a little bit more time. So with that, when we're talking about random acts of kindness, what does that look like? How do we paint a picture and how do we make those random acts of kindness truly come to life? So let's talk about a couple of different things. For many of us, we have great talent and skill. Now, many of us have even birthed new businesses out of this situation, and we definitely want to monetize our gifts and talents to have the necessary stream of income that we need. Also, it's a great way to also give back. So let's talk about a lot of different things that we can do virtually. Most of our lives are virtually now. So when we're talking about if you have a fitness class that you can give virtually, maybe you could do, if you own a gym and you were a fitness instructor, maybe you could probably offer a virtual class for senior citizens. and how to help them stay fit because they may not be able to get out as much. How about those of you who know how to sew? Please, someone help me, teach me how to sew because I love sewing and I used to do it as a little girl and I hate that I never kept up with it, but I want to learn how to sew again. So offering a class of the basics of sewing. What about reading to children? Offering some time during the week as we're getting ready to go back to school. Maybe that's something that you could offer to parents or people who you know locally in your community who have to teach their children at home to allow them to be able to take a quick break, then you could be the one to provide story time for the children. And also offering times of meditation. Self-care is of the most importance, but also allowing people to have the opportunity to meditate. You could offer this as a class, a curriculum. This could be something that you could help for parents, busy students. So to be able to offer that time of meditation and also arts and crafts. One of the things that I remember the most being in school, and I don't want to date myself, but when I was in school, home economics was the classes that everybody wanted to be in. How to cook, how to sew, arts and crafts. And unfortunately now with the way the school system is set up, we don't get to offer that as much anymore. So it's a great opportunity to bring back those basic life skills that we could probably share with our youth, share with our teenagers, share with our middle school students to help them as we are thriving in this new way of living. So let's also talking about beautifying the community so we can still social distance and beautify our neighborhoods. Maybe it's someone that cannot get out as much as they used to, maybe due to some health challenges, maybe due to the fact that they're a little bit older. How about helping to plant a garden or helping in their flower bed or just being able to cut the grass? In our local areas, if you have a park that is close to you or you're on a particular road, taking the time to maybe clean up the trash and clean up that particular area so we can continue to beautify the places around you. It's nothing more beautiful than driving past a beautiful garden of flowers and roses and just taking in all the beauty that God has created. So we talked about home improvement. We talk about beautifying our community. There's an app called Next Door App. It is an outstanding app that you can use particularly for your subdivision or a particular zip code. And this also allows you to correspond with those people in your local community. It's very much like a Facebook, but it's for your neighborhood. So it allows you to share and exchange information. And it's a great opportunity to even do wellness checks for some people around you who are in your close-knit group. In a particular subdivision that I lived in, we had the Next Door app. So it was good that we could share information and correspond with each other. Even if we didn't have the opportunity to be, if we were out of town or somewhere else, we could still know what was going on within the neighborhood. So a couple other things that you can do, as I was looking at some information through the United Way, and I have been serving with the United Way for many different years, also donating to the United Way for many different years. They have something called virtual volunteer, which is very much the same thing as offering the virtual classes, but they have a portal that you can go to see what their needs are. And it may be something within your particular skill set that you may be able to offer to some people around you. Be it math classes, reading classes, basic school fundamentals, maybe even some tutoring that you would be able to do to be able to help our parents and help our students at this time. There's also a website called pointsoflife.org that has a big list of all the different places who are looking for volunteers, as well as your local shelter or food bank. Now, again, with the pandemic, we understand that we have to do our part from a social responsibility. And some of these places, you will probably need to call to make sure that you are meeting their protocol and what their needs are and what the guardrails may be. But let's not also forget foreign languages. This is a great time to learn a foreign language. And if you're fluent in a foreign language and you have an opportunity to teach someone to speak a different language, this is a great opportunity to do a virtual event to help someone to learn a different language. So one of the other things that I remember that I used to do when I was a lot younger is pen pals. Getting a letter in the mail from someone unexpected can really warm your heart. I was in the post office the other day, and the lady that was before me, because I was sending out some packages that to some of my clients and some of my customers, and this lady had postcards. And I was like, wow, when was the last time I sent a postcard to someone? Just to drop a card in the mail to tell someone hello. Just to drop a postcard in the mail with a beautiful picture on it, just to say hi. Now, there is an app that you can send a postcard directly from your phone. Technology is so amazing. So you can, whatever picture you have in your phone, you can now turn in that into a postcard, put your note on there, and send it directly to your friends and family members. That is such a beautiful surprise to have in the mail that someone received a postcard from you. So wellness checks are good, especially when we're talking about ministry. If you didn't already have a cell group that was already put together within your particular ministry or organization, now is a great time to put that together. So what are we doing? Say, for instance, you have a ministry of 100 or 150 people, or maybe 500, and you have a group of people who are willing to volunteer and do wellness check on your members, divide that up into groups of 50, maybe even groups of 10, depending upon how many people you have, just to have a few people to call them and check on them to see how they're doing. Because for many of us, being in the church was our lifeline. And now that so many people have not gone back to church, it's good to make sure we keep that close connection and to check on them. So let's go back to the virtual part. Zoom has been a friend for many people, just like we're using Zoom tonight to do this virtual class. You also have Microsoft Teams now has a way to do a connection. Facebook now, you can create rooms. Sometimes it's good just to say, okay, y'all, we're going to meet up tonight just to check on each other and just to check in. I know on television, I've been seeing a lot of television shows where girlfriends are getting together just to check in and just have a just a little powwow. I know my son, while he was doing his internship, they did virtual happy hour. It was the coolest thing. So he had an opportunity because he was working with people all around the world who are part of this internship for the corporation that he was working for. And every evening around about 5:30, 6 o'clock, they did virtual happy hour. So we have so many great things that we can do to stay connected. Now, when we talk about the homeless, when we're talking about those who may be struggling financially, or that family that may just be overwhelmed, care packages are such a blessing. So let's take the new mom with the new baby and smaller children or other children that she may have. To have a gift basket of meals already prepped is amazing. You may have someone that may have to be a caregiver for someone that may be sick. I know when I was taking care of my husband, when he was ill, it was a blessing for someone to bring me breakfast, lunch, and dinner for the next couple of days because I had two small children. I was taking care of a husband and I was working. And it was such a blessing to come home to meals already prepped. I didn't have to do anything but pop it in the oven, put it on the stove, and it was already taken care of. It may be someone who may have recently had surgery. A couple of years ago, when I had to have major surgery, I had a wonderful, wonderful group of a community of people that I had a meal every night for the week that I didn't have to worry about cooking for myself or my family, and my children were still pretty young. So meal prep is a great thing to do, especially if that's something that you love to do. Maybe it's an elderly person who needs someone to prep their meals for them, or someone that may have someone with special needs, or someone that you may be a caregiver for. To be able to prep their meals for them is a relief and an opportunity for those persons to not even have to think about, that's one thing I don't have to do. How about a project in a box? If you are amazing with crafts and you are the one who could think of all of these great things to do, from the small ones up to the older ones, a project in a box is amazing. So you'll take a box, all the tools and resources that you're going to need, put them in there, and that one box could keep them busy for a long time. When was the last time you colored in a coloring book? Do you remember coloring in a coloring book and all the time you spent making sure you stayed in the lines to make sure your circles were real pretty, your colors were nice, you had the dark ones and the light ones? There's so many adult coloring books out there now, even the ones for children. Are you a creative that can create coloring books for adults, maybe middle school kids, to kind of give them an outlet? And also, one other thing that we can do is share our resources. When we think about all the information that we may be privileged to, maybe creating a hub where individuals that you know, the group of people that you know, being in corporate America, a particular organization that you have, you can share resources. And I know a lot of people are doing this on Facebook, but if you're not a social media person, maybe you could put together some type of directory to be able to help people and let them know that these are the resources that are available to you, so that they can take advantage of the many of the different resources that we have at this time. So one of the other things I want to talk about is really near and dear to my heart when you have an opportunity to do this is adopt a grandparent. Many of our elderly, they don't have anyone to come and visit them. And I know some of them are in nursing homes where they can't have anyone to visit them. But for them that may live alone, who their partner is deceased, their children are grown, or they may not have had any children, and they may not have a lot of people around them, there are some resources out there that give you an opportunity to adopt a grandparent. Because their family may not be very close to them. So it gives you an opportunity to share your time, some smiles and some stories, and also to gain some wisdom by adopting a grandparent. One of the other ones is blood donations. As you know, with many of the things that we have going on, the American Red Cross is in need of blood donations. And also those who have an opportunity to donate plasma. It's very much needed at this time with many of the individuals who may be in a critical condition, who may need blood transfusions, and also who may need plasma to help them to get well. So the American Red Cross is another way that we are able to share what we have. Now, when we talk about business owners, one of the things that we can do as business owners is also give scholarships to some of the different things that we offer as a corporation, as a business. Again, we talked about particular classes, it may not be your ultimate program that you may have that you offer, but maybe it's a program that may be scaled down a little bit, but it's some information that is useful that can impact the community, impact the kingdom, and impact the people around you, that you would be able to offer those classes at a discounted price or for free. So we always want to sow those seeds of kindness to be able to share with the people that are around us. And I want to look up this app very quickly because I want to make sure you get it. Bear with me just for a moment. Because I thought it was the cutest thing when I saw the postcard app. It's called My Postcard App. And I think you can also do it through Shutterfly. You can do it as well. But it's called the My Postcard App. And it is on Google Play. So it gives you an opportunity to take those wonderful pictures, turn them into a postcard, and send them to the people that you love. For those who you may know that may have a child that has special needs, a care package for the parent that's taking care of that child with special needs. If you have an opportunity that if they don't have a risk factor for health, but you could probably give them a break for a day, or for a couple of hours. For anyone who has been a caregiver, taking a nap is the most beautiful thing you can experience. So even if you have an opportunity, someone is close to you and you have everything in order from a social distancing or even a social responsibility for a risk factor for COVID, and I know we want to make sure we take care of that, just to be available for someone to just rest for a couple of hours is good. Now, also, just to be able to laugh is the best medicine you can give anyone. So many of us know that we have that one friend or group of people that I just want to connect with you to laugh. I just want to see how you're doing. I want to just bring some sunshine to your day. Be that person just to call. And I know we have a group of people that we may not have spoken to in a while, but if there's someone that God has laid on your heart, serve your community by just checking in on them to see how it is that they're doing. So these are a few things that you can do to serve your community. I need to probably look and see if we have anything in the comments. Tanisha, I don't know, was there anything in the comments that you saw or any questions that anybody have that I want to be able to share before we get to maybe a close or an end tonight?
There's no questions. Roz was making a few extra suggestions, such as like adopting or, you know, taking time with the child of a single parent. Also,
I saw she put a model submarine together.
Right.
How about a real big puzzle, the big 1,000-piece yeah. puzzle with the tiny pieces? Mm-hmm. Walking with a grandparent. Yes, adopting a child in a single parent home. Oh, I want to highlight Mom Lander. She's giving a class for young girls. She's doing a virtual class for our preteens, or tweens that I call them, which is a great, great opportunity for them to have an outlet for our youth so that they can be blessed. And just checking in, just to let people know that you love them, sending someone dinner, Uber Eats, DoorDash, Grubhub, so many of the different things that you can send someone a meal. And of course, volunteering with Meals on Wheels. I have a good friend of mine. She just started, her name is called Tashi Creations. She just started a meal prep and she was so kind because I had a busy day And I had spoken to her about, so she said, girl, I'm about to bring you some chicken Alfredo. And oh my God, it was the best meal that I had had. And I had had a long day. So those are just a couple of things that I wanted to share with y'all, that we can still give our time, give our talent, give our love, give our kindness, because we need so much joy in a time such as this, and to be able to be that beacon of light for someone, to shed some love, to shed some light, to share our heart, and to just wrap our arms around someone in many different ways when we can't physically hug people, but we can hug them by giving. We can hug them by sharing. We can hug them by letting them know, I am thinking about you. So these were a few different ways that we can serve our community with love and compassion during a time when we need it the most. So ladies, gentlemen, for all of you who are on here tonight, that is my time. I thank you so, so very much for spending time with us tonight here at When Women Heal. If you have any questions or any other suggestions, please drop them in the comment, because we want to be able to share as many of our resources and information that we can to be able to help the people around them and to bless them. I love you all. Have a blessed, blessed Monday night for the rest of your evening. Have an outstanding week, and we will see you again next week. Take care.